there's always a level of trust that needs to be built.
An Iowa financial group at the center of an investigation over missing millions. It's raising questions of who you can trust with your money. Now, we are learning more about what led investigators to a Cedar Falls investment firm that lost $225 million in client money.
The Blackhawk County Sheriff says a note left by Peregrine Financial founder Russell Wesendorf Sr. at an attempted suicide on Monday prompted them to notify the FBI. Now, the sheriff is not releasing details of that note, but the next day, the Commodity Futures Trading Commission filed civil fraud charges against Peregrine. They accused Wesendorf and his firm of misusing customer funds and failing to keep client money separate from company money. Well, these latest allegations may have you wondering if your investments are safe.
Angie Hunt is in our Ames Live Link. Angie, what can investors do?
Well, financial advisor Kurt Pearson says ask a lot of questions and make sure the person handling your money is willing to be accountable to keep your investments safe. Allegations of fraud and millions missing from this Cedar Falls Financial Group is reason for consumers to be cautious about their investments. Peregrine Chairman Russell Wesendorf Sr., seen here in a previous story, is accused of misusing customer funds. It's another example of why investors need to do their homework and ask questions.
There's always the risk-reward test. Yeah, if I take more risk, there should be some potential reward. If there's really low risk being promised and high reward, that's an immediate flag.
Financial advisor Kurt Pearson says Peregrine Financial Group traded commodity futures, an investment that comes with a lot of risk.
And that is always one of the most aggressive, speculative types of asset classes that an investor can consider or get into.
There is oversight by the SEC and the Commodity Futures Trading Commission, but should there be tougher regulations?
I think it's more a case, are these agencies doing the job that they're supposed to do? Of policing the industry.
Pearson says unlike investments in stocks, there are different rules for commodities. To protect your money, Pearson recommends asking the following questions. Where does the money go once it leaves your bank account? Who are you writing out the check to? Who's creating your investment statements? And is your financial advisor going through a broker-dealer?
Most financial advisors are going to have a broker-dealer. And that is a healthy thing because there is a level of oversight. Most broker-dealers have a compliance department.
And Pearson says there's nothing wrong if your financial advisor is acting as their own broker-dealer. But again, just keep in mind that it takes away some oversight and be sure to do your homework and ask questions. As for the oversight of the Peregrine Financial Group, Iowa Senator Charles Grassley says he will be asking some questions of those oversight agencies to see how this missing money went unnoticed.
Awesome. Great information there, Angie. Thank you.